Are you struggling to get more consistent sales on Etsy? Well, stay tuned because by the end of this video, you'll have 5 actionable tips, my secret tips on how to get more consistent sales to your Etsy shop. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Linda, and as you can see by all my other videos, I'm a crafter, but now I help women, creative women just like you, turn your passion into profit and grow and build your online business through Etsy and beyond. So if you like the tips that I share, if you like what you see here, I'd love to have you as a subscriber. Make sure you hit that bell notification so that you'll be notified when I upload new videos each and every Thursday. So also, I'm going to put a link in the comments where you can download your free digital product guide. Now, this is a guide that I wrote that will help you think of new ways to offer the same product. It helps you work smarter, not harder. I know there's a lot of useful information. I'll put the link below and you can get your free copy. Well, just so you know, everyone struggles with ebbs and flows in business. Even the biggest businesses on Etsy have better months and slower months. But with that said, if you're experiencing a dip in your sales that is persistent, or if you've had low Etsy sales, well, we need to do something about that. We need to fix that problem for you. So as I said before, by the end of this video, you'll have 5 action items that you can implement right now, right after this video is over, that will get you on your way to getting consistent sales with Etsy. And we've heard it said before, it's not personal, it's business. But, you know, to a creative, to an Etsy seller, it is personal because we're the makers. We're the ones that put our heart and soul into that product. And so when we have low sales, we take it personally. And I know, as a fellow Etsy seller, I know how that feels, but try to think of it literally as business. All sales are really a numbers game. You either have the sales or you need to get the sales. It sounds pretty easy, doesn't it? But for a creative business person, what we don't like is working with numbers. Numbers are scary. We like the creative part, but we don't like the business side. But it's so vital because action item number one, tip number one, is you have to know your numbers. You have to know where you can grow from. And so to do this, I want you to go to your store manager. I want you to scroll down and click on stats, and you're going to look at 2 different numbers. The first number is the amount of visits you had. And the second number is the conversion rate that you have. So visits are obvious. It's just like a store opening. A visit is a person walking through the door. And the same way to your Etsy shop. A visit is someone who has clicked on your listing, your photo, and come to your store or viewed your item. Now, conversion rate is the amount of people that came to your store that actually bought. So in other words, if you have 100 people visit your Etsy shop every day and you have a conversion rate of 3%, that means 3 people bought your products. So 100 people came through your door, 3 people bought, you now have a conversion rate of 3%. So in order to grow your sales, you need to get more people to see your shop, your listings. So the more people, every 100 people that come through, you're going to get 3 sales, 200, you're going to get 6 sales, and so on and so forth. But the other way to grow your sales is to increase your conversion rate. So getting the attention of more of the same people. So instead of only 3 people buying, you've gotten the attention of 5 people out of that 100. So now your conversion rate is 5%. So you don't necessarily need more people. You just need to maximize what those people do in your store. So those 2 numbers are really, really important because it's going to give you a foundation and a benchmark in order to measure your future success. Know your numbers. So action item number two, optimize your listings with SEO. Now, SEO is search engine optimization. If you're new to the online space, that could seem like a big scary word, but essentially what it means is to make sure that your descriptions have really good searchable terms. So if I was trying to find my mugs, for instance, inspirational coffee mugs, I would have that in my title because that's what they are. They're mugs with inspirational phrases and Bible verses on them. So you want to make sure that your listing titles and your listing descriptions are very clear, that they have searchable terms and keywords. How that increases your sales is that little box at the top of someone shopping at Etsy, that little search bar, when they type in inspirational coffee mugs, and my listing says inspirational coffee mugs, guess what? Those two meet. And they have the opportunity then to click on that listing. Once they click on that listing, I have an opportunity to convert them into a buyer. So make sure your search engine optimization is very clear by using searchable titles and keywords. Very vital in growing the sales on your Etsy shop. Action item number three, people buy with their eyes first. So we have, as an online shop, a slight disadvantage from a brick and mortar store. With a brick and mortar store, you've gone by the window and you see that beautiful sweater or blouse or whatever it is in the window and you go in because it's caught your eye. It's the picture, it's the visual. You've already bought it with your eye. You're curious about it and you want to see more. So you go in and you get that sweater and you see that, oh my goodness, it fits me so well and it's so warm and it is so soft and I just want to cuddle with it. Well, now you're enticed to buy because it's touched all your feels. Your sense of touch and your eyes, and maybe inside the store they have a lovely fragrance, a candle burning. So all of your senses are ignited and you are excited to take that sweater home and cozy up with it. But see, that's the disadvantage we have with the online store. So we kind of have to make that up in people's minds. And the way we do that is with beautiful photos. They buy with their eyes first. So you have to show them every aspect that that particular product can do for them. The first photo, though, you want to make sure it's on a very clean background with no props so that they get a clear visual of what the product is. And the subsequent photos, you can show different sizes. Does it come in different colors? Does it, maybe you measure it around so they can get a visual of how big it is. Maybe you show that in a styled version. Where is it going to live in their house? How is it used? Or what does it look like on? How long is it? So on and so forth. You have to mentally paste the same picture in their mind that they would get when they go into a regular brick and mortar store. And again, people buy with their eyes first. It is so important to have beautiful photos on your Etsy listing. Make sure you have at least 5 photos, 10 if it fits. If it doesn't fit 10, that's okay. But at least 5 photos showing the size and the color and all those good things that make that customer want to purchase from you. Action item number 4, and this is where social media comes to play. So we're kind of stepping off of Etsy a little bit, and now we're driving some traffic, especially if you're new. It's helpful to drive some traffic. You can do this regardless of whether you have a following or not. There are 2 platforms I feel like you must be on if you are on Etsy. They work really, really well with Etsy. The first one is Instagram. If you don't have an Instagram account, I urge you to get one. Instagram is full of beautiful photos, and this is where your audience is going to connect with your products, with your brand, and with your story. They want to know about you. That's why they shop handmade businesses. That's why they shop small businesses. That's why they go shopping in little boutique stores, because they want to get to know the store owner. They want to get to know you and what you stand for. So Instagram will help you build your brand story. The second is Pinterest, and Pinterest is so vital because it is a huge search engine. Now, with Pinterest, people go to Pinterest because they're looking for something. They're looking for a recipe or an idea of what to cook for dinner, or they're looking for a gift for someone special. They're looking for an idea. Whatever it is a search engine. It's like the better form of Google because it has more beautiful pictures. So make sure that you put your items up on Pinterest. Again, using SEO, using that search engine optimization, making sure your descriptions are very clear, and sending the people from Pinterest over to your Etsy shop. Now, I will give you one little bit of info. Is that when you send people from Pinterest to Etsy, it's Etsy's business to sell as much as they possibly can. So unfortunately, they're going to show other people's listings. You may also like this. Hey, you may also like that. Again, why your photos have to sell them the minute that they see it. Because when your photos capture their eye, they're going to hang out a while on your listing. They're going to look at all those photos, and then they're going to go to your shop and they're going to look at all the things that you have in their shop or in your shop. When they do that, Etsy will say, hey, this shop must be pretty interesting to people, and it will boost your rank, and they will start showing you to more and more people. So you want to get the eyes from Pinterest over to your Etsy shop. Make sure your photos are clear. Make sure that they capture, and that's how your customers will hang out for a while. The longer that they're there, the more they will be apt to buy from you. Action item number 5. And this is probably the biggest. Yeah, it's the biggest. Do you have any idea what it is? Well, here's the thing. When you have a customer on Etsy, when you have a follower on Instagram, and when you have followers on Pinterest, you don't own them. You have no way to like mass contact them. If any one of those platforms goes down, so does your business. So it is vital that you attract your customers to a mailing list. You own the mailing list. That's the only thing that you own. That's the only thing that you can guarantee that you will have. But now you're asking someone for a pretty personal piece of information, right? Somebody you've never met before, and here you're going to ask them for their email. So the easiest way to do that is to give them something in return. In the business world, we call it a lead magnet, and I don't really like that name because I think it's a little, I don't know. I just don't like that name. I call it an incentive. You're going to give them something for giving you their email address. And what can that be? Well, it could be that digital product guide, like I mentioned that I have before, that it's a 5-page guide on how they can work smarter, not harder with the products that they already have. And again, I encourage you to download that because it may give you some ideas for your product. So in exchange for your email, I'm going to give you a free product guide. Like I said, 5 to 7 pages. If that's something that you don't have the ability to create, and that's fine, or you don't want to create it, that's fine. Maybe you have a freebie. Maybe you give them maybe a free cut file. Maybe you give them a incentive discount. I hate discounts. I don't like to do discounts. So let's call that a value add. You give me your email, I'll give you free shipping. Or you give me your email, I'll give you a free gift with purchase. Something like that. Something to incentivize your customers into giving you their email. Because your email will be your business goldmine. I guarantee it. So those are my 5 actionable items that you can implement as soon as you get off of this video, as soon as you finish watching this video. So let's review them really quickly. 1, you have to know your numbers. You're going to find your numbers under the shop manager, the stats, and then you want to take a look at your visits and your conversion rate. The more visits you have, obviously, the more sales you make. So if you have 100 visits and you have a conversion rate of 3, you're going to make 3 sales. So for every 100 people, you're going to make 3 sales. If you get 1,000 people, you're going to make 30 sales. The other way is to increase your conversion rate and keep the same number of people. Number two, optimize your listings with SEO. Search engine optimization, make sure those titles have searchable elements to them. Make sure they're keyworded really well. Make sure that they are very clear and convey the message of what your customer is purchasing. Tip number three, or action item number three, is that customers buy with their eyes first. Make sure your photos are on point. Action item number four. So we talked about how social media can drive business to Etsy. Etsy does a great job getting customers to your store. But if you're having a little bit of low sales, you can also help that out by optimizing and connecting with your followers on Instagram and on Pinterest. And the biggest tip, if you don't take any of the other things away, which you really should, but if, I mean, you have to do this. I talk about this in my membership group. You have to do this. You must grow your mailing list. It's the only thing you own. It will be the lifeline to your business. Offer an incentive and get their email address. So I hope that you can implement these suggestions. Don't get overwhelmed. Just do them one at a time. Do them at your own pace. The last thing I want you to do is to get overwhelmed and quit. But these are five action items that I know that will help you grow your sales into daily sales. This is exactly what I use to help me, and I want to help you as well. So remember, every Thursday, I upload new videos on how to sell on Etsy. So make sure you subscribe and make sure you hit the bell notification. Leave me a comment below. Let me know what you sell. Give me a tag, what your Etsy shop is. I'd love to come and browse your store. You never know. I would love it. And maybe I'll feature you on a video. I would love to do that. So until next time, until next Thursday, I hope you have great sales and I wish you lots of success on Etsy.